Namaste YouTube, welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our reaction to Frank Zappa's Po-Jama People. This is a Patreon request by our patron James. And Po-Jama People is the first time ever that I am listening to anything like this, a term like this. The closest I can think of is Pajama People.
I'm clueless about this song. What does it mean, the title? And it's along with the title is, I think, the musicians who played with
Frank Zappa.
It's called Frank Zappa and the Mothers of Invention.
Yeah.
And the title is Po-Jama People. It's from an album that we have reacted to a bit earlier this in the last month. One Size Fits All.
Yes.
We have reacted to a song.
Inka Roads was from this one.
One of the songs was definitely from this album. So we'll have to check our playlist, maybe later we'll realize and you guys will know. So it should be interesting because that song was interesting. If it was Inka Roads,
Inka
it was
Roads.
Our first.
I think it was Inka Roads.
The second one was where he's out of the swimming pool, I remember.
Yes.
It's something like that, an empty swimming pool as a pool cleaner or something. So let's get started with this. I don't think I have any clue about what this could be. I mean, like you, I think it's Pajama People.
Pajama People.
Pajama, as we call in India. So who are these guys? We'll only know once we listen to it. Perhaps you may not know even after listening to it.
Yeah.
One thing is for
that's
sure.
That's what is special about Pranjab.
One thing is for sure that it's going to be a treat for us. It's an acquired taste, Frank Zappa's music. And I think I've acquired the taste, and so has she. Let's get started with the first time single take on a and pure reaction.
If only they knew it. Pajama people are boring me to pieces. Feel like I am wasting my time. They all got flannel up and down them, a little trapdoor back around them, some cozy little footies on their mind. Pajama people, pajama people, they sure do make you sleepy with the things they might say. Pajama people, pajama people. Mother Mary and Joseph, I wish they'd all go away. Pajama people, it's a pajama people special. Take one home with you, save a dollar today. Pajama people, pajama people. Pull them out of my way. Hey, 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 hey. Oi, oi, oi. Get them out of my way. Hey, 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 hey. Oi, oi, oi. Get them out of my way. Hey.
Oh,
people's cold, and some people's not very swift to be home. Some people do it, some see right through it, and some wear pajamas if only they knew it. The pajama people are boring me to pieces. They make me feel like I am wasting my time. They all got flannel up and down the hall, a little trapdoor back around the hall, and some cozy little footies on their mind. Pajama people, pajama people, people. Lord, they make you sleepy with the things they might say. Pajama people, pajama people, people. I wish they'd all go away. Pajama people, pajama people special. Take one home with you and save a dollar today. Pajama people, pajama people. Wrap them up and roll them out. Get them out of my way. Hoy, hoy, hoy. Wrap them up and roll them out. Get them out of my way. Hoy, hoy, hoy. Wrap them up, roll them out. Get them out of my way. Hoy.
So far from Frank Zappa, this song is special.
Incredible. The guitar work, the piano work, both of them together for so much time in this song. Those solos went on. This was special. This was special. We can totally ignore the lyrics and just enjoy the music.
Music
in this
by
song,
itself, yeah.
And we will love it. We will love it. We will love it. But on Enoma, we don't do that. We tend to focus. We tend to focus a lot on the lyrics as well as the experience of reacting to the music. Both are equally important on this particular channel.
Yes.
I loved it. I loved everything about this song. I think I have a pretty good idea what he's talking about.
Okay.
Who he's talking about, but I'll let Kirti have a first say. Maybe she knows, maybe she doesn't. Either way, how did you enjoy this one? The guitars, the piano, the light drumming in this one, I think. The vocals of Sir Frank Zappa, and what else do you want to talk about?
You know, for me, forget about the lyrics. I really can't get into his head and understand what he's trying to tell. But I do have a rough idea what is going on here. But I love the music. I loved the music. I found the vocal parts, the time when he's singing, very, very funny. But it gets crazy serious when he's on the guitars. The guitar solo that happened for such a long time. I felt at one moment if I was clapping, my hands would be tired, but the guitar solo went on and on and on. This was a treat. This was pleasure listening to his guitar solo in this one. It was serious guitar playing.
Definitely.
Superb, superb. This is one of the best pieces that we have heard from on the guitar. This will make in top three
top
for me.
Top ten for me.
I loved it so much.
In this year's reactions that we've heard.
Yeah.
Definitely sublime. There's something pretty artistic about the way Frank Zappa created his music. Which is lacking in many of the musicians we react to, we listen to, we react to. The thing that's lacking is that, you know, they focus so much on one thing and leave out the other. Frank Zappa takes up very strong issues. You know, And the Slime is an example. You take up a very strong issue, you portray it in your own way, that is art. If you just portray it like everyone else, that is not art. It's just copied. So for me, this is what makes Frank Zappa different from everyone else. He makes it his own. You cannot say this is inspired from or copied from this musician.
Well, this sounds like that.
Yeah,
this
you can't say it because he has his own style.
You know, stamped all over.
Yeah, you know this is him. And secondly, he gives so much importance to the music, you know, the guitar and the other instruments that are playing in every song. There's so much importance given to it. It is a very, very important part of the song. Not like most of the other musicians, again, who just sing and make, you know, give music to back up the singing and it's done. I don't like song like that. You know, I mean, I do have a few favorites, of course, which are like that. But if I'm reacting as a first time listener, I want something more meaty, you know, something with more substance. And that substance must come in the form of the music as well, not just the lyrics. The lyrics needs to be good, but at the same time, if it's, you know, backed up with great solos, great instrument work, it's great. I love this song mainly for that reason, because it's refreshing for me as a reactor after you listen to a lot of other songs, which more or less are in one or two categories. It's refreshing to find a song like this, which just comes in an altogether new category, a third category. So that's what I'd like to say initially. Kirti, now is the challenging part for you. Okay. And I'm not going to come first, because I think I have a good idea what he's talking about here. Maybe because I'm a Christian, I kind of connected it with more. Okay. What are your thoughts on this?
I get that.
I could be wrong.
No, I was not in that direction, but I do
no,
get
No, you
it
have
right
to
now.
Say your direction.
I'm giving my direction. I won't get into yours.
One direction.
But one direction. Let me, one thing, you know, I have to say this thing. What happens when a band or a musician gets music out? There are two motives. Two or there are many more, but basically there are two things that play a major role. One, either they have to fulfill the contract of the year, how many songs they are going to publish every year or, you know, come out with. And there is another that has to be, it's so personal that I like getting it out. I want to communicate with people through that music. This is my personal view. This is, I'm talking about the musician, not right now about me, that they have a personal view or on something and they think they have to give it out to their fans. And let's see how the fans also react to it. Frank Zappa comes in the second one, not the first one, where, you know, we have to fulfill our targets. We have the timeline and things like that. And we have so much to do. And let's just throw whatever you have and let's make something around it. This song for me was very personal from his side. He's talking about his personal things, how he feels like. Even though it may have been, you know, making music in general, but this was very personal. The way he sang it, those hooks, I can't even do it well. But it was all funny and it was very personal, the way this music was made. As if you are interacting with him, how he feels about things, how he feels about pajama people and pajama special. Take one of them and go. And you'll save a buck or two or whatever. So, for me, this was about any person, or there are so many things. For an example, I also don't like certain things in the society. I don't like certain people who represent those things and, you know, do those things. So, I say these people are just waste of my time. I hate them to the pieces. That's what he said. I really don't like them to the pieces. Not about, you know, little bit likeness. I hate them, hate them, hate them. So this, the pajama people for me, anybody in general, who he doesn't like spending his time on, wasting his time on, he just likes them to be rolled out of his sight. He wrap them, roll them out of my sight and I'm happy. And, you know, infuse this lyrics in a great music composition. That's what he did. So he's talking his heart out with his fans and he's saying that these are the kind of people I think where you are going, it's about priest.
No, but that's where I'm going. What did you think?
I guessed you, right?
No. Okay. But what were you thinking?
I'll tell you. I thought he was also talking about roll them and wrap them and things like that. People who take drugs. Because we have a feedback system now going on our private forum of the patrons, and I realized that our patron for Frank Zappa reactions isn't very happy, very, very happy with the things that we share. So I thought of doing research on Frank Zappa himself, and I found out a lot of things. I can share a few which are golden, like he got his entry into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame so late in his career in 1995, almost 30 years being in the industry, and he gets entry. I wonder if, you know, a musician dies before that 30 years of lengthy career, do they still give them? entry?
I don't know much about that.
Okay, so it took him really long time to get into that. In 1997, he got Lifetime Achievement Award in the Grammys. So these two things, you know, a big deal. And also I found out in his profile that he hates people. Doesn't hate, actually he is not a supporter of the people who take drugs, his fans, the people who follow him. And he tells them, you know, he's one of those responsible musicians who is very concerned about his fans. And if somebody at his concert or, you know, somebody is taking drugs, he will stop and he will tell them not to do it. So he's one of those responsible musicians. I was very, very happy and proud to know about that.
Okay, that's your view, and that is how Frank Zappa probably was. Mm. He definitely sounds like a gem of a guy, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, he may be, some people call his music eccentric or different, or that's his music, but I guess as a human being, if that's what
gem
he did,
of a guy. Yeah.
He's a gem of a guy. My interpretation is that he's here in this song, he's not talking about drug addicts or something, or pimps or the drug peddlers on the streets.
Uh-huh.
He's talking mainly about holy men who are attached to temples, churches, you know, and other religious institutions who are willing to do anything, you know, they are willing to do anything in the name of the Lord.
Mm.
So they are willing to molest kids.
Ooh.
They are not willing. It's not that they are told to do that. They want to do it.
Yeah.
Because they're that desperate at times, many of them. And you can see the number of cases that keep coming out almost every day, especially in the West where it's more open. These cases keep coming out and it goes right up till the Vatican, where people have to apologize in the Vatican for this kind of behavior by the priest associated with the Vatican.
Mm.
So this is that bad right now.
Yeah.
And I guess he's talking about them because, you know, they talk so much. They give so many sermons. They tend to bore you. You know, most of them bore you. There are very few people, priests and religious people, who actually can captivate the audience for hours on end, or for even minutes on end. You know, in today's world where we have a very short attention span, I guess it must be even more difficult for priests to, you know, captivate the attention or spark the imagination or spark the interest of a person on Sunday in Sunday Mass. So he's talking about them, that they preach, they do a lot of things behind the closed doors, they have back door entries. And a lot of other things were mentioned, I guess I caught a few of them.
Mm-hmm.
So I connected with it,
now.
You know.
Yeah.
It's a lot of things that they do in the name of the religion, of their position in the religion, or position in the society, in the church. And they get away with it. The sad part is they get away with it. So he's saying, you know, he's bored of it. He's bored of them. He's bored of everything they stand for. He's strongly against them. He dislikes them. He says, you know, because in Sunday Mass, what we were thought to do is to give some of our pocket money or earnings to the church.
Oh.
So even though I would get very little pocket money, you know, while growing up, I would get perhaps more than most other kids my age, because I had a big family and all of them would chip in and give me some pocket money in. So I have been the youngest in the home. So I would get this pocket money, and my mom and others would tell me, you know, whoever I went to Mass with, mainly my mom and my other family members, they would say you have to give some of it to the church. So I grew up doing that, and sadly, I love God, I believe in God firmly, but when it comes to the institution surrounding it, I have my serious doubts about how they can help you live a better life or help you in any way, really. You know, and this is, I don't like saying this, this is something which takes a lot of courage for me to open up about. So I guess this is about it. And if it's about drugs, as she says,
no, I think
that could be right too.
Right
it could
thing.
Be right too. It could be right too. That's the thing with Enoma. We are not afraid to make mistakes.
Yes.
We do not go through other sources. And, you know, what Kirti did, I think, is the first time or second time she may have done.
I thought there is a need to
research.
Do that.
I think you should stop doing that, because that is not what we have, you know, started this channel for. It's not a first time honest reaction if we start doing research on things. So we should just focus on the music we listen to, and that should be our topmost priority, because that is what we are here to react to. Not the man, not the woman, not the musician. We are reacting to the song.
Yes.
There could be an artist who has 10 fabulous songs, But the 11th and 12th song we hear from that artist is not good at all. At least for me. I tend to say that. People don't like me. Many of the people in our on our channel, they love me. And there are few who don't like me one bit because I am that kind of a person who when it gets to the 11th and 12th song that I do not like, I say it. I say that this is not that good.
Yes.
Or I say it in my own way. I may not even say it. I may say it like Frank Zappa. Po-Jama people.
Po-Jama
so people. That's how I word it myself. I would word it in a similar way. And people won't even realize it unless they actually pay attention.
Yeah.
Because that's my education and upbringing. That it's put in a very diplomatic, polite way at times. So you don't even realize that I'm saying it. You know. So that's about it for this one. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Goodbye.